intoxicating smell of the graveyard. Once a year, we gather beneath our family tree to honor the great cycle of life and death. Come, every member of our clan.
Fester.
Pugsley.
Wednesday.
Grandma.
And let us celebrate what it is to be an Addams. Come to me, Morticia, my luscious wife. Oh, she of skin so pale, eyes so black, and dress cut down to Venezuela.
Oh, Gomez.
And tell us what it is that every Addams hopes for.
Darkness and grief and unspeakable sorrow.
Mi amor.
Gomez, will you love me forever and ever?
We shall be as besotted with each other as the night we met.
Our first date you took me to see?
Death of a salesman.
How we laugh.
And now we summon our beloved ancestors. Why do we do this?
Because living or dead, family is still family.
Yes, and how do we do this?
By dancing on their graves.
Yes, dance my brother Fester. Time to wake the dead.
When you're an Addams, you need to have a little moonlight. When you're an Addams, you need to feel a little chill. You have to see the world in shades of gray. You have to put some poison in your day.
That's the way when you're an Addams.
You need to have a sense of humor. When you're an Addams,
you need to have a taste for death.
Death rattle.
we have a problem. Little Wednesday Addams, that charming, irrepressible bundle of malice who had poisoned her own brother just for a trip in the ambulance, has grown up and found love.
Ew!
No.
Disgusting.
So here's the deal. Gather around. I'm not letting you back into that crypt until love triumphs.
Faster.
No!
So who is this Lucas fella? Is he worthy of her? Do they really love each other? What is love anyways? Does this rash look serious to you?
Ew!
So many questions about love. But when you think about it, is there anything more important?
Dad, I have something really important to tell you.
What?
Can you keep a secret?
Of course.
Look.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say that looks like an engagement ring. What are you saying?
Oh, Dad, Lucas wants to marry me.
What?
Lucas Beinecke loves me and he wants to marry me.
Do you want to marry him?
Yes, I think so.
You think so?
Well, I've never even met his parents and he's never met mine and I just need to be sure.
That he is the one.
That the families can get along. I mean, he has to know what he's getting into.
What do you say?
I'm saying we're who we are and they're from Ohio.
Ohio? A swing state?
That's what I mean.
You're right. This is important. Let's go tell your mother.
No!
No, but we have to tell your mother.
Dad, please. She'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
You don't want me to tell your mother you are getting married.
After dinner and we're all friends, then we'll tell her.
But I've never kept anything from your mother before.
Dad, just one tiny little secret. Please? Please?
Okay. I promise I won't tell your mother.
Mother always said to be kind to strangers, but she doesn't know what they've strung. I can feel the clear and present dangers when she learns that the boy has got me pulled in a new direction. But I think I like it. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. And this feeling I know is impossible, so I'll confide that I've tried, but I can't let it go. It's disgustingly true. Pulled, pulled, pulled. Puppy dog with droopy faces, unicorns with dancing mice, sunrise in wide open spaces, Disney World, I'll go there twice. Butterflies and picnic lunches, bunches of chrysanthemums, lollipops and pillow fights, and Christmas Eve, sugar plums, string quartets and chia pets, and afternoon banana splits, angels watching as I sleep, and Liberace's greatest hits has got me pulled in a new direction. If they keep insisting, I'll stop resisting. Just watch me pulled in a new direction. I should stay in the dark, not obey every spark, but the boy has a bite better far than his bark, and you bet I'll bite too. Too was truly taboo as I'm pulled in a new direction.
Something's wrong with Wednesday.
What do you mean?
She's in the kitchen smiling like this. I think it's this boy.
This boy? Don't be silly. Ha, I say, and double ha. Ha ha. You yourself said puppy love. Come, darling, I feel an urge to take you in my arms. Let's go upstairs.
Gomez.
On the other hand, she is a healthy young woman like you were, are, like you are. She could even fall in love and get married like you did.
Don't be ridiculous, Gomez. I'm much too young to have a married daughter.
Yes, but
What if, and I have no reason to say this, but what if she did meet someone who stole her heart?
Don't be silly. When that happens, I'll be the first to know. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you do.
Yeah.
Gromaz, you do tell me everything, don't you?
Of course.
Oh my, you're perspiring.
What?
I hope you're not coming down with a case of liar shingles.
No.
I think Wednesday and I shall have a little chat.
Okay, Lucas, enough is enough. Give me the map.
I don't see any houses.
That's because there aren't any, Alice. We're in the middle of some godforsaken park.
Central Park, dear. Designed in 1857 by Mr. John...
Wait. What?
I know where we are. It's where I first saw her. I was lost in the park and a pigeon fell at my feet with an arrow in it. I looked up and there she was, Wednesday, with a crossbow.
A what?
A crossbow. You know.
You mean this girl walks around with a crossbow?
It's okay, Dad. She has a permit.
Good. Good choice, son. Okay. Now listen carefully. Here's what's going to happen. We're going to go back to the hotel, and then you and I are going to have a little talk.
Be patient with him, dear. A father should support his son, and Lucas is your only one.
See what you did, Lucas. Your mother's rhyming again. Now, let's get back to the hotel, and then...
No one normal night, not one poem, not one inspiring word, one normal scene, complete routine, tonight can't be absurd, please don't embarrass me or be completely rude, don't make a fuss about the house, about the food, whoa, one normal night, I know it's big, but can't you see, this one normal night is for me.
And this is Cousin Helga from Baden-Baden.
Who's that looking over her shoulder?
Oh no, that's her other head.
She has two heads.
Well, you know what they say.
And who's that man in the dress?
Oh, that's Aunt Herman, Wednesday's uncle. And here's Gomez and me at our wedding.
What's that?
Our wedding vows.
That's so romantic. We promised to tango at least 3 times a week.
For passion.
We promised to tell each other everything.
For truth.
Everything.
Of course.
And you're still married?
More than ever.
Boy, it sure doesn't work that way in our house.
How does it work?
Well, it's good for the gander as a nice quiet goose. If I told Mal my secrets, all hell would break loose.
Alice, I'm shocked. What kind of a marriage is it where you keep secrets?
A long one.
Keep no secrets. Welcome honesty with no resistance. Then your marriage is a loving kind of coexistence. Lies and secrets, they're the sins that keep a husband from a wife. Gomez loves me, he would never keep a secret in his life. Misquoted, always the paragon. And if he told you a lie, you'd whisper goodbye, then leave him to carry on. Is there no room for some discussion? Is there no chance you might forgive?
Hi, Grandma.
Hey, son, how's life?
Too long.
Tell me about it.
Hold on. What are you doing?
Restocking Grandma's private stash. Herbs, potions, remedies, nature's candy, no prescription needed.
What's that one?
Spookily. You got someone giving you a hard time?
Maybe.
Sprinkle a little of this on his toast, and an hour later, he's in the padded room screaming, I am Spartacus.
Grandma, what if there was this girl who met this person
And he's all like, it's the Pugster, what up, little man? And she's all like, golly! And we're gonna go now. Now they're running away together. What would you give her?
Nothing. She's your sister. Be happy for her.
But what if she doesn't get rid of him? What if all the good times are already behind me?
That's life, kid. You lose the thing you love.
Tell me about it. What's this one?
Acrimonium. You want to stay away from this baby.
Why?
Takes the lid off the id and brings out the dark side.
What do you mean?
One swig of this and Mary Poppins turns into Medea.
I don't understand your references.
Well, stop texting and pick up a book once in a while. Now quit whining and start thinking about you and how you're going to live your life. Time, my dear, is a thief. She'll steal your soul and flee on little fairy wings. Now stay out of my stuff. I'll rip your leg off and bury it in the backyard. I love you.
What if she never tortures me anymore? How would I manage? What if she never nails my tongue to the bathroom floor? What if she walks away, leaving me a-okay, hiding each power tool? Why would she be so cruel? I could stab my arm myself, could rip my tonsils out, could set my hair ablaze. I could spray my eyes with mace, but face the fact, without her, it wouldn't be the same.
Let's not talk about anything else but love. Oh. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Can't we talk about lofty goals, mating souls, altering minds and faltering roles? Let's not talk about anything else.
It warms me up to see you live in large. When I'm crazier than you, much crazier than you, I'll drop the plan, you'll be the man in charge. All this time and all I needed was the hope that you'd submit. Too afraid and too conceited to believe that you were it. But the journey's not completed.